Hello, we're TopWhat. Let's have a look at some things.
You know this feeling? Finally getting cozy. There is nothing better than lying in your bed after a long, hard day of work. You went to the gym afterwards, cooked some dinner, had a great 20 minutes wank. Done for the day, man. Fucking knackered. You're content but exhausted, and you're just going to sleep. All tucked up and warm under your blanket and just snoozing away. But suddenly, your body is like...
Ta-da! No, sir! Let me kindly demonstrate to you what it feels like to fall off the fucking cliffs of Dover. Interesting, innit? You're welcome! We've all experienced the sudden full-body twitch you sometimes get when falling asleep. Good grief, what's the bloody point of that? Utterly annoying, and now you're completely awake again, eyes wide open, gasping for air, and a heart rate of 100-year-old after a marathon. What was that? It is, in fact, a very common phenomenon which has different names. The hypnic jerk, the hypnagogic state, or just the sleep start. It varies in intensity. For some people, it's just a huge muscle spasm. For others, it's a small shock or a bouncing feeling. Around 70% of people experience hypnic jerks in their lives, and especially children, according to the BBC. Some of those small little accidents go unnoticed, though, or we have already forgotten them by the time it is morning again. Speaking of the hypnic jerks, not the children, mind ya. Now, the first question that comes to mind is, why on earth when we fall asleep and when we are at our most comfortable? Why then? Why doesn't it happen in the middle of the day? Scientists have not got to the bottom of hypnic jerks yet. We know they are sudden muscle spasms, and there is a neurological battle between the part of your brain that wants to keep you awake and another part that would very much like you to fall asleep. There are different theories on why hypnic jerks happen. The first and most common theory: when you go to sleep and relax, especially after a very active and stressful day, your whole body and your nervous system relax. But during that process, your nerves aren't getting the job of cooling down done properly, and they misfire, causing those sudden muscle jolts. That is because the awake part of you is still overstimulated, and that's how it shows. And that explains why it only happens during the transition from wakefulness to sleep. Another theory includes that our brain sometimes confuses falling asleep with literally falling off somewhere, so it quickly sends signals to activate your body to take action and protect you. A last idea states it's an evolutionary mechanism. Your brain makes you wake up one more time so you can check whether you've taken all necessary safety measures for the night. As annoying as they are, hypnic jerks aren't dangerous in any way, so there is no need to be afraid of them. Since the cause is still unknown, we can't really avoid them. But we can take some steps to lower the risk of experiencing a hypnic jerk. For instance, no alcohol or coffee a few hours before bedtime. Don't exercise hard late in the evening or at night. Do some meditation or breathing exercises before sleep. Just try to get through your day without completely exhausting yourself and draining yourself of all your energy. Also, strap yourself to your bed so you don't accidentally falcon punch your partner in the fucking face in the middle of the night. I imagine this is the most terrifying waking up experience you can get. That's all for now. Thanks very much for watching. Subscribe if you like. Oh, and also like the video and comment below. See you next time. Do you want to see my beard? Wanna feel my beard? Wanna feel my beard?